I think I'm gonna play another song about my feelings now. So this is a song about sort of a version of a breakup, yes. So it's another one of those. It's more about the idea of moving on from a breakup. You know, I think the worst part about a breakup sometimes, if one could choose a worst part, would possibly be if you get out of the relationship and you don't recognize yourself, because you changed a lot about yourself to make that person like you, which I never do. I always do. And I think that for me, it's like, I wrote this song about the idea that you could remember who you used to be, and you could kind of remember that by meeting someone new who makes you feel like it's okay. Like everything about you is great. And not only is it okay, like who you are, it's awesome. And you could meet someone who celebrates the things about you that the other person used to criticize you endlessly for. You know, and I think that that was an interesting thing for me to write about, the idea of actually moving on and there being hope after the crash and burn that always happens. Not always. I believe in love. It doesn't always happen. But, you know, I think that this was an important song for me to write, like, as just, like, personally. And the fact that it came out and you guys made it number one on iTunes was really, really nice of you. So thank you for doing that. This is a song called Begin Again. Took a deep breath in the mirror. He didn't like it when I wore high heels, but I do. Turn the lock and put my headphones on. He always said he didn't get this song, but I do, I do. I walked in expecting you'd be late, but you got here early and you're standing with. I walked to you. You pulled my chair out and helped. Begin again. You said you never met one girl who had as many James Taylor records as you, but I.